Since MH370 went missing on March 8th of last year, authorities have searched more than 4.6 million square kilometers of the Indian Ocean, hoping to find any sign of the missing airliner. At first, they focused a surface search in the South China Sea and the Strait of Malacca, near where last contact with the plane was made. A week later, they shifted the search south to the Indian Ocean, based on radar information and where the plane is believed to have veered off course. A few debris sightings in March shifted the search underwater. Sonar and ocean floor mapping technology started soon after. All in all, 22 planes and 19 ships could not find any trace of the aircraft. So authorities went back to the data. An analysis of radar and satellite communications indicated the plane was likely along a specific arc in the southern part of the Indian Ocean. The search area was then redefined. A deep underwater search was launched in early October in the new search area. How did they come to that? MH370 used an Inmarsat satellite system to transmit its position. Each time a handshake with the satellite is established, a ring of possible locations equidistant from the satellite in space can be plotted on the Earth's surface. Authorities believe the plane was on autopilot throughout the mysterious flight, the whole time sending out these electronic handshakes to satellites. After adding aircraft speeds and altitude to the data, and accounting for when the plane would likely have run out of fuel, the search was then focused in this region along the 7th arc. The wider search area spans 60,000 square kilometers along the arc. Authorities hope to finish mapping the entire area by this May, and hope even more so to end one of the great mysteries in aviation history. Jonathan Mann, CNN.